Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects 3DP. Today I'm going to present you a couple of 3D printer upgrades that I've made and are almost generic for any 3D printer. I will try to keep this video not too long, so I won't enter into very small details. But stay tuned because I'm sure you're going to love these products, and there is going to be a giveaway at the end of the video. Starting with the first product, if you own 3D printers and you use them, after 5, 50 or 500 prints, the printing surface will end up looking like that. If you remember the Architects 3D Pre-i3 that we built in the series Build the Best DIY 3D Printer and you loved, I didn't even have a printing surface itself. As you can see, we have been printing lots of stuff directly on the backside of the heated bed. And to achieve that, we did it using hairspray, glue stick or any other method to make it work. I have used so much some of the printers that we reviewed in the channel, such as for example the Gitech 820, that as you can appreciate, it has been a very reliable machine, but clearly has had better times. The heated bed, as you can see, is completely destroyed. And it is not an isolated case, since if we have a closer look to the LOTMAX SC10, it is so destroyed everywhere, as you can see. And that is where OSEQ enters the game. They sent me these 5 packages that I have right here, and as you can see inside, we'll find these really cool printing plates that are made out of metal and have a special coating for the print adhesion. Feel free to go ahead and have a look at their products at oseq.io. They have different build plate sizes, but as you can see, they send us 5 that are the same size, in this case 240 by 245 millimeters. We could install one of them in the Architects 3D PA3, by the way, increasing the printing volume, as well as on the Gitech 820, where we'll miss some print surface. But back to the LOTMAX SC10, I'm going to remove the clips that hold the print bed in place, and I'm going to replace it with the OSEQ printing surface, which as you can see is not big enough, but will get the job done. As you can see, I have holded it with bigger clamps to make sure it's not going anywhere. Since the bed is metallic, the holding mechanism here looks very rudimentary. It would have been really cool to have a magnetic base in between the bed and the printing surface, but they didn't send me any of them. I hope that if they are watching the video, they take it into account. They contacted me some time ago, and they explained me that they were creating a new company in the Czech Republic, and they were starting the business. So I hope this video helped them out with the launch.
Having a look at their website, I've just noticed that they already have a total of 15 different sizes, which is really cool, and also strong magnetic stickers of all sizes, what I was complaining about some seconds ago. Guys, go to oseq.io and check out these cool products. Remember that you will also find the link down in the description. As I said, guys, go check them out at oseq.io for more info. Now that the printing sheet is installed, I'm going to show you their coolest feature, and it is that when we warm up the print table, look at this surface sign right here at the bottom, guys. It is so cool that lets us know when it's ready to print, and what I think it's more important, when it will be cold enough to remove our 3D pins from the bed. Alright, so the last thing will be to test how it actually works, so I'm going to start a new print. Despite the nozzle being a bit high from the printing surface, it's stuck to the bed perfectly, and as you can see, the print is a complete success. To remove the safe sheet once the print finishes, we should wait until this red sign disappears. I don't really have time to wait until it's ready, so I'm going to remove it and leave it here on the table. And after a couple minutes, as you can see, the red is not as bright as before, so I'm going to remove the print. As you can see, with a little pull, it came out of the bed just perfectly.
As I said, guys, go check them out at oseq.io for more info. Now we're going to continue with a really cool product that will allow you to make this kind of time lapses. It is not made with Octoprint or using a Raspberry Pi or anything like that. I'm going to show you how it was made after introducing today's sponsor, that is no other than PCBWay. PCBWay is your website to not only get your PC prototypes the easy way, but also other services such as 3D printing or CNC machining. Today I have some good news in that area, since at PCBWay they have made an in-depth cooperation with FreeCAD, the open source parametric 3D modeler that I'm sure a lot of you use. Now, once you finish your design in FreeCAD, you can place an order on PCBWay with just one click. To use this service, you just have to go to Tools and Add-on Manager, choose PCBWay from the selection list, and click Install. To find more information, please check out the link down in the description.
Alright, so the timelapse I showed you before has been made with this little product that was sent to me by Mintion, and it's named the Beagle Camera. As you can see, it is a plug-and-play device that works with most of the printers, with auto-timelapse function, temperature monitor, and you can access it via browser or their smartphone app from anywhere, anytime. It records in up to 1080p and works in the 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network.
Trust me, it is a really cool device.
When we open the box, we'll find the quick guide. The camera itself, as you can see, is quite cool. And finally, the USB-A to micro-USB cable to connect some printers, the USB-A to USB-C cable to power the device, and the power brick itself that we'll use to connect it to the wall. As you can see, it is compatible with most of the printers in the market. We have reviewed quite some of them, but for the test, we're going to use one of the latest machines, the Longer LK5 Pro. So we'll plug the USB-A cable right here and the USB-C cable here on the side. As you can see, a 32GB microSD card came with the camera. And finally, we'll connect the power brick here on this end. They claim that you can use the box as a stand, but you can 3D print cooler stands that you will find on Thingiverse or anywhere else on the internet. So after plugging it in, we'll remove the protector here at the front and we'll find a little problem. And it's that we have nowhere to plug in this microSD cable that came with the camera. So we're going to pick up the USB-A to USB-B cable that came with the printer and we'll just plug it in place just like that on the camera and also to the 3D printer. Once everything is connected, both lights will light up and in the app we can click on connect. It is really crazy that we can control the printer with just our phone, from anywhere, and watch on stream the movements of the printer. I've made an auto-home, and as you can see, it is going down. I am going to set up the temps for a print, and look at what I see in my phone, guys. As you can see, we can even watch a graph of the temperatures of the nozzle and the bed, and also move the printer as easily as you can see. I'm going to upload a new print from my phone as easily as that. And once the temps are ready, the print will start. And I can watch it live from my phone. As you can see, the benchy print has started and what the camera will do is to, after finishing every layer, it will send the extruder to the back left corner of the printer and will take a picture of the resulting layer. Here we go. Then it will continue with the next layer. Here we are a couple layers later and as you can see, it will send the extruder to the rear left corner and then continue with the print. In our app, we'll see all the details we'll be able to see on the screen of the printer or even more. And here we have the final result, guys. It is a bit overexposed, since the material is white and I'm using the studio lights, but even so, the result is very cool, isn't it?
I've made a couple more tests with the Beagle camera, so you'll have a look of what you'll be able to do with this cool device. As you can see, it is so cool, guys. You will find a link to buy the Beagle camera from Mintion down in the description. But maybe you are the lucky guy to get the second Mintion camera that we are going to give away. To participate, you just have to subscribe to our YouTube channel, leave a comment down below with the words Beagle camera, and follow both of us on Instagram at Architects3DP and at Mintion Tech. That's it, guys. You will have 1 week from today to participate. The deadline will be on October the 19th. The winner will be announced on both Instagrams a couple days later, on October the 21st. That's it for the video, guys. I wish you good luck with the giveaway. And please make sure you are subscribed to the channel, consider supporting my work on Patreon as all these amazing people does. And as always, see you in the next video.